Hey Internet, welcome to Thermodynamics Tutorial 5-78E, the E represents English units, this is an imperial question. We'll go to step 1, draw your free body diagram. You get a point for drawing a picture related to the question. It also helps you visualize the problem. So we've got cold water going in, and it's being warmed up by the steam. So it goes in at 50 degrees Fahrenheit, and it leaves at 65 degrees Fahrenheit. The steam is constant at 75 degrees Fahrenheit, and it is condensed steam. Okay, next up, we list the givens, and we're trying to find the unknown. You don't get a point for this, but it helps with the formula, or finding the formula. Step 2, find the formula for the heat transfer rate. Starting from first principles, energy in minus energy out is equal to energy of the system where it is approaching steady state, which is zero. We bring the negative energy out to the other side to balance the equation. So for the inlet, we've got some heat transfer rate, we've got mass flow rate multiplied by the inlet enthalpy. On the exit side, we've got exit enthalpy and the mass flow rate multiplied. And our finished derivation of the equation is heat transfer on one side. We've got mass flow rate, which is constant. This Cp delta T is equal to delta H, so the change in enthalpy. So that's where that part comes from. Alright, so we are missing Cp, so we need to find that for step 3. So to do that, you add the average temperature of your cold water. 50 plus 65 divided by 2 is 57.5. So you go to your table, which is at the back of your textbook. If you bought the PDF, you can use your search function and type in your table A-3 by pressing Ctrl F. So 57.5 is in between 90 and 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So your Cp is probably in between 1.01 and 1.0. So you do your linear interpolation. Here's the general formula. And you'll find that it'll be 1.00 something rounded down. So we're just gonna call it as 1.0 for the Cp. Alright, now that we've got all the values, we can plug it into the equation and find the heat transfer rate. So step 4, find the heat transfer rate for the exchanger. So you've got your mass flow rate given in the question, and then you've got your temperature given. The Cp is what we just worked out. So you multiply everything and you get 675 BTU per second, British thermal units per second. And that's your heat transfer rate. Step 5, find the formula for mass flow rate for the steam. So since there's no area, we use the heat transfer version of the mass flow rate. So heat transfer is equal to mass flow rate multiplied by the evaporation enthalpy, or the enthalpy of fluid and gas. So what we do is rearrange by dividing the enthalpy to the other side. Now we'll cancel that side out and it becomes a division on the other side. So from there, we just worked out our heat transfer rate. We're missing our evaporation enthalpy, so we need to find that. Step 6, find the HFG, the evaporation enthalpy, at 75 degrees Fahrenheit at the condensed steam. So we go to table A-4E, go to 75 degrees Fahrenheit. And we go to HFG, the evaporation enthalpy. if you do not have this on your table, what you do, it is HG minus HF. So for students, I'll just quickly write out the formula. So HG minus HF. All right. So you'll get 1050.9 BTU per LBM. Now that we have that, we can backtrack and find the mass flow rate. So step 7, find the mass flow rate for the steam. So 675 BTU per second, that's what you figured out for the first part of the question, which is step 4. And of course, your HFG, your evaporation enthalpy, is what you just worked out at step 6, right over here, by looking at your table. So that will give you 0.642 pound mass per second. Disclaimers, the method is correct. However, I do make calculation mistakes. I encourage you to solve it yourself and see if you get the same answer. Thanks for watching. Hope you had a great day. Be sure to like, subscribe, share with your friends, ring the bell, turn on all notifications, leave a comment below if this was helpful. If you want to support the channel, become a member, or drop a super thanks. Until next time, see ya.